Assalamualaikum everyone, my name is Najah Musfira binti Isha and now I will explain what is corruption. Generally, corruption can be defined as when those in position of power such as managers or government officials act deceitfully. Corruption destroys trust, undermines democracy, stifles economic development and worsens inequality, poverty, social division and environmental issues. Government servants demanding or accepting money or favors in exchange for services, politicians squandering public funds or awarding workers or contracts to their sponsors, friends and families, and corporations paying authorities to achieve favorable terms are all examples of corruption. Corruption adapts to shifting situation and environment. Changes in rules, legislation and even technology might cause it to change too. Next, according to scholars Hidden Hemir, he described that corruption as a breaching the rules of a particular office, working against the public interest economically and acting against the public interest. Scott has come up with a somewhat different definition of corruption, which is breaking the law, acting against what the public perceives as honesty, or working against the general interest. According to Aluko 2009, corruption is a complex phenomena. It is not a sole demand of any nation, race or region of the world. Rather, it crosses national boundaries and limits, symbolizing phenomenal worldwide unwholesomeness from a political standpoint.
Now, we will proceed to the next point where I will explain about the issues of corruption in news. When we are talking about corruption, it is like we already know that the topic has been too common in our country as it always been displayed in the news for the public, which is for me, it is a good thing. The first corruption issues in news can be seen about the issue related to the delivery of littoral combat ships. In this issue, the government of Malaysia has already paid RM6 billion for the first ship, which is scheduled to be delivered in April 2019, although no ship has yet been built. The Malaysian Anti-Corruption Commission or MACC has received a complaint from Bosstet Heavy Industries Corporation Berhad or BHIC on alleged anomalies in an RM9 billion littoral combat ship LCS project. In addition, the former Deputy Defence Minister Liu Chin Tong informed the Dewan Negara in September that Putrajaya's Procurement, Governance and Finance Special Inquiry Committee had determined that RM1 billion of the RM5.94 billion paid for the battleships could not be tracked. After several investigations have been made, MACC detained two project CEOs who were on their way to MACC headquarters to give testimony as they were accused of receiving bribes through payments sent to a corporation in another country, as well as bribery from a subcontractor hired to monitor the project. The second issue of corruption in news is regarding the McDonnell MD-503G helicopter. According to reports, the Defence Ministry ordered 6 MD-530G light scout attack helicopters from MD Helicopters, a subsidiary of US aerospace firm McDonnell Douglas, in 2016. Unfortunately, the Royal Malaysian Army has spent RM300 million for helicopters that were never delivered. Malaysia's Defence Ministry has filed a complaint with the country's anti-graft agency requesting an investigation in the non-delivery of 6 helicopters worth RM300 million that were bought in 2015. These two issues have shown that the elements of corruption do exist in the defence sector in Malaysia. This matter is indeed worrying because it is one of the important ministries in our country's government. The corruption that occur will cause huge losses in terms of money due to the allocation given has been misused.
So, next, I want to share to you about the implication of the corruption in the government defense sector. So, the first implication is that it can really tarnish the government defense sector reputation at globally. Did you know that our country, Malaysia, has only been ranked D in the GDI index? So actually, what is the GDI index? GDI index is the Government Defence Integrity Index, which has been used to assess the effectiveness of the government defence sector. So, because of the corruption that has been happened in the government defence sector of Malaysia, it's made Malaysia only being ranked D in the GDI index. Malaysia also get only 45% in the GDI index from the 100% full mark. So this really give a bad reputation and really tarnish the Malaysian reputation at globally, especially in the government defense sector. This is as Malaysia only being ranked D compared to other countries like New Zealand, which has been ranked A in the government defense integrity index. So you can see that because of the corruption that has been happened in the government defense sector, it can really give a bad effect towards the government defense sector reputation.
But first, on how to overcome this problem, the Malaysian government must establish a special select committee on defense under the jurisdiction of parliament. This special select committee is a sub-legislative body that consists of a small number of members of parliament from government and opposition blocs. Any activities, budget, procurement and so on that involve the defense sector will be asked and examined by this committee. This is because all the money that has been used must be used for the right purpose and cannot be distorted by those who want to steal the money. The committee will be led by one MP from opposition parties because they want to create check and balance. Hence, when the issue arises, especially if there is some misconduct or corruption involving a lot of money, the committee will call a responsible person to answer any question. The responsible person who needs to attend and answer the question is the Minister of Defence itself and Chief Secretary Ministry of Defence. The Minister is responsible to answer any question that has been raised in the committee, and he is obligated to give any information, financial transaction and so on for the committee. The committee will do a financial audit on where the money goes and if there is some misconduct or corruption happening during the activities of buying defense equipment and so on. If the minister didn't want to answer the question, he can be charged under the standing order of the parliament, and this can bring a bad image for the government. For example, during Pakatan Harapan administration, Muhammad Sabu, who is former of Ministry of Defense, has proposed white paper in the parliament to expose any misconduct, abuse and corruption of power in the defense sector during previous government. The Pakatan Harapan government want to investigate where the financial activities in defense sector, but it didn't happen after the changing of government. As a country who practices the Westminster system, we must follow good action from the United Kingdom because they have had this committee since era Margaret Thatcher, and the Secretary of Defense always attend to this committee when they are being called. Committee will publish any policy, budget, financial and so on to the public, and the public will know where the money goes. Hence, the people will give trust to the government because they are responsible and open to the public about the inquiry investigation by the special select committee. This can help the Malaysian government to achieve transparency and accountability in the defense sector and put Malaysia on the right track to achieve high points in good governance of Transparency International.
Corruption and security concerns with the government military contract must be highlighted, particularly in the light of the demand of the high standard for defense contract, national and international. In the line with the national defense objective, which mentioned that the government will ensure a good governance practice in strengthening the defense sector by consolidating transparency, accountability and action in pursuing organizational transformation. As a result, in order to execute high standard for defense contract, the government is dedicated to increasing bilateral defense relationships with nations in Southeast Asia, the wider Asian region and the rest of the globe. Malaysian military sector can create a room for international market to join open contract in order to improve procurement effectiveness. Not only that, the open contract could enhance the defense relation in R&D between country. Moreover, due to the high cost of defense procurement, allocating procurement contract to the public will boost the domestic economy while reducing ringgit outflow. Thus, there is a fair competition and open to tenderer in obtaining defense contract. However, filtering and auditing is required when accepting local and foreign company to guarantee that the firm is viable and capable of offering quality service. The government may also enact a new defense procurement process based on the particular defense sector capitalization standard in order to assist local businesses in increasing industrial competitiveness and developing national strategic projects, as well as ensuring that they suitably qualified and experienced public personnel are developed across the department to enable transparency and environment in procurement process. It provides ethical and control conduct of the defense sector, which to avoid corruption at all level of the organization, as well as they assist to evaluating performing and developing way of working to maximize effectiveness in in delivery required outcome. Lastly, the government will continue institutionalizing a good governance through the conduct of check and balance within the Malaysian security and defense sector in line with the principle of accountability and transparency, as well as ensuring the security provider operating effectively in accordance with the legal and policy framework as mentioned in the Defense White Paper Blueprint. In conclusion, we must embrace transparency in order to combat corruption. Knowing who, why, what, how, and how much is all about transparency. It entails bringing formal and informal norms, goals, procedures, and action to public. Transparency allows the public to hold everyone in power accountable for the common benefit. In order to lessen or prevent corruption in Malaysia, the defense sectors can apply the Freedom of Information Act, collaborate with civil society, be transparent with the public, implement anti-corruption tools in defense procurement, or the defense force can collaborate with the MACC. So with that, the corruption in Malaysia can be prevented. So that's all from our group. Thank you.